What a difference for good you can make as you get directly involved in the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. We want to help you to make that big difference for good. So be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. What a big difference for good you can make as you get directly involved in the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. Gather up your youth group, bring them on down. Have them help prepare food for people that are in need. Have a fundraising drive for the New Life Evangelistic Center. Become a club member. There's so many ways you can make a big difference for good as you get directly involved. There are so many people that are hurting, so many that are in need, the poor, the fatherless, the widowed. But what a difference you're making as you care, as you share. I praise God for our faithful volunteers, for those that are making that big difference, those that gather up food and help serve the hungry and hurting, those that will help have special fundraising drives. What a blessing you are. I want you to hear from some.
Hi, my name is Brad Dunacek. I'm part of the Gateway City Church. We came here this morning with open arms to serve the needy. We made some delicious tacos and some lemonade, and we had a great time this morning just helping people, seeing the smiling faces, and really showing them not our love, but the love of Christ and the love of God. That's what we're here, is to lead people into a growing relationship with Jesus Christ. And we hope and pray that just through this little act, we can serve others, we can teach them just a little bit, not about the Word of God, but about how He is, what He does, who He is, and how He behaves. So we're really fortunate to have the things that we have in life to give to others, not to hold to ourselves. So we are part of the Young Professionals Ministry Pulse. My fiance and I do a enjoyable job of helping to lead the group. It's a great group of people who truly love one another and love others.
Whether it's making tacos, gathering up blankets, actually getting throughout the community and having everyone you know to help share food, which so many hungry people need here at New Life Evangelistic Center, or sharing your much-needed tax-deductible gift, you're making a big difference for good. Many people coming to New Life Evangelistic Center at this time because they have nowhere else to go. Tell us your name.
Nick.
Nick, you came here. You didn't have anywhere else to go?
No.
Nick, tell us about your situation.
Well, actually, recently I just lost my employment. And basically, there was, you know, Salvation Army shutting down, and I can't get into Peter and Paul. And actually, I've been coming to the 14 days since about 2009, and I know this is the only shelter that will accept anybody off the streets, because, you know, that's...
So you came here to New Life Evangelistic Center because you have nowhere else to go.
Yes, sir.
His story's not alone. There are many, many people just like that, nowhere else to go. And it's to New Life Evangelistic Center. They're coming in growing numbers at this time. Now, tell us a little bit, is it helping you grow closer to Jesus by being here?
Yes, sir, because, you know, it's around the to people around, you know, that this community, you know, actually, I've been to one Friday. I did come to a mass here on a Friday, where you get the extra night. And
So you came here to...
I've been to one of the masses here. So, uh-huh. You know,
Yeah, we want you to know that God loves you in every way, that the Lord loves you. And we try to help with as many nights, as many opportunities, many different opportunities for people to grow in God and use their God-given talents to help others that are in need. Yes, people that had nowhere else to go, finding themselves homeless, coming to New Life Evangelistic Center. And then they're learning skills that they're able to share with others. Even issues, even things like solar cooking. That's right, people previously homeless, getting in the training program, learning about solar cooking. So during this program, we not only want you to meet people that are getting help, we want to give you some ideas of ways that you could perhaps get some help. For example, how to cook without utilizing that electricity and that gas and utilizing the sun. Well, I want you to hear from one of the brothers that was homeless out on the streets, now in a training program out in Marshfield, Missouri, as he explained some solar cooking to you.
Hi, my name is Daniel. I'm here at the New Life Earth Day Energy Fair. I've got solar cookers here. A solar cooker is basically a crock pot. It's a slow cooker that traps the sun's energy in a box and cooks food, a box or an oven bag. And you could prepare any kind of food you want using a solar cooker. You just need sunlight and some basic materials. They're constructed from plywood, and you just paint everything black so that they absorb the sun's energy. It's the basic design is a box within a box, so it's insulated more or less just like your home. You've got the inside box and it's a little smaller than the outside, and then you just put whatever kind of insulation you'd like to use in between. Some types of insulation might work better than others. It's just kind of trial and error. These are constructed, I think, with fiberglass insulation, and we've got aluminum foil here reflecting the sun's light. That helps to amplify the sunlight and warm up the food a little better. These are going to work best when you've got direct sunlight. The time for cooking is approximately twice as long as you would use for a conventional oven. And what you're going to end up with is some delicious food prepared in a solar cooker.
Nice. Got a job working at the New Life Evangelistic Center, teaching other people about solar cooking, sharing with individuals, growing in the Lord Himself, continuing through the power of God to discover what it is to be a new creation in Christ. You've made all that possible as you've shared, yes, shared hope. Nick was out on the streets. He was homeless. Nick was indicating earlier that he had nowhere else to go. He came to New Life Evangelistic Center. He's gotten in a transitional housing program. Nick, what are your dreams, your hopes for the future?
Well, I want to try to, like, you know, of course, when I'm here, you gotta get back in the church. And right now, I'm going to try to, like, get my disability. But whenever I get, once I get that taken care of, I would like to get back into school, because back into maybe computer programming, mm-hmm. or like when I first always I wouldn't. I love animals, and a vet, you know, might be another something that I might be interested in going back to school for. You know, get more education for that.
We're trying to help Nick fulfill his dreams. First, drawing into close to the Lord, and then letting God's light and love flow through him. I praise God for those of you that have been praying for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. And people that you're hearing and meeting were once without a home themselves, and now they are training and helping others. Jay is one of those individuals. Jay is in Marshfield, Missouri. Been with us for a while, was homeless, came to us, now helping other homeless people. And Jay's going to share something very practical with you, because I think there's a lot of you that are getting fed up with continuing to see the price go up and up, up at the pump. And he's going to be showing you how you can actually make some biodiesel utilizing used vegetable oil. Yes, and bear in mind that the man that's training you was often cast off, like society does frequently, to those that are homeless. But what does the Lord do? He takes a life that the rest of the world has cast off, infuse it with the power of His Spirit and with the Word of God and the resurrection message of Jesus Christ, and it becomes productive fuel. In the same way we take the used vegetable oil, mix it with methanol and lye, becomes productive fuel. Well, now, those that are coming to know the Lord Jesus, those that are getting the new opportunities at New Life Evangelistic Center, becoming productive fuel. Keep that in mind as Jay shares with you some very practical direction on how he's making biodiesel out in Marshfield, Missouri.
All right, my name's Jay. I'm here from Marshfield. Right now, I'm showing this gentleman here how to turn around and do a triazation and a mini batch on biodiesel. Now, actually, what I'm trying to do is turn around and show the public how to make small batches, 5 gallons or so, to turn around where they can turn around and make it in their garage or in a shed or whatever, where they can turn around and save the fuel. Now, the process of how you do is your triazation for your mini batch is your triazation is the same thing for a 5 gallon batch. All right, you turn around and you measure out 1 liter of distilled water. Okay, you take 1 gram of lye. You put that in your water and dissolve it. Okay, now after you dissolve that, you turn around and what you do is you take a smaller container, whatever. You take 1 milliliter, which is the first line here, of the oil, and 1 milliliter of your alcohol. Okay. You put this in the glass, then you turn around and you take 1 milliliter and put it of your water and your lye. You mix it up, stir it up the best you can, and what it does actually is your lye is turning around and it's breaking down the oils. So it'll mix in with your product, so it'll turn around and work properly. All right, now you turn around, you take your test strip after you mix it. Dip it in here. And you have a scale which is on your, this particular scale, you want in between the 8 and the 9, the color there. All right, that what that shows you is your triization is correct, and that's how with your formula, you turn around angle 3, 2.5, plus whatever you have a scale with that. It's in the book, and it shows you how many grams of lye to use for your 5, 10, 15-gallon batches. If I would have turned around and had your test strip wouldn't have turned around and came out the right color, I would have had to add another milligram, so it's 2 plus 3.5, and on. So more drops you put in it, the more you have to add to your batch. Now this particular batch, I only had to turn around and do this one time. So that means 1.3.5, which comes out for a 5-gallon batch, it comes out 45 grams. So then what you do on your 5-gallon batch after you do, you take your container and you want to take a gallon of methanol and 45 grams of your lye and mix it in as best you can. Get it to dissolve. You want it crystal clear. Then you turn around and you take 5 gallons of your vegetable oil, plus your gallon of your methanol and your 45 grams of your lye. You put it in a bucket and you turn around and blend it for an hour. Then when you let it, after an hour, you let it set overnight, at least 8 to 10 hours. It'll cause the glycerin and your lye, all your impurities and your glycerin will go to the bottom and your biodiesel will come to the top. And you just dip it off and filter it and you can use it for your car.
Jay was just showing you how to make biodiesel. Now, you can use that both in a diesel vehicle and also you could use it in a kerosene heater, but use just a small part of the biodiesel with a lot of kerosene, and then you could perhaps add more as time goes on. You could also use it instead of home heating oil, biodiesel. A lot of uses for biodiesel. Now, you want to find out more about biodiesel and other forms of renewable energy, go to www.moreenergy.org. That's www.moreenergy.org. Stay tuned to 24.2, where they have 24 hours renewable energy. That's in the greater St. Louis area. Now, if you live outside the St. Louis area and you can't get 24.2, you can see the same programming at www.AmericanRenewableEnergy.org. That's www.AmericanRenewableEnergy.org. We're trying to help people help themselves. Many people come to us whose utilities are about to be shut off. Many of them are shut off. We try to help them. I'll tell you more about that in just a little bit, but I first want you to meet Dietra. Dietra came to us as a homeless woman, right?
Yes, sir.
What does it mean to you that you've gotten that kind of help here at New Life Evangelistic Center?
You are helping get back on my feet. You feed me, clothe me. And I consider you as my Christian family because when I'm not around my family, you all are able to help me in time of trouble.
It's hard being a homeless woman, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Very hard being a homeless woman. And it's hard for many women today, many single moms. Many, many people right now are facing homelessness. Others are facing the shutoff of the utilities. We try to help them every way we can. That's why we distribute the compact fluorescent light bulbs to help people save on their energy bill. That's why we try to help them as we receive resources to try to get their electric back on. We also try to talk to them about utilizing solar power and wind power and many different other forms of renewable energy, because we have so many people that are coming to us right now with their electric shut off. They're hurting, they're in need. I want to go to Ray as he talks to one such individual. Then I want to come back with one of our trainees later in the program, talk to you about solar power, alternatives to the big utility companies. But first, let's go to Ray.
I'm talking with Luella Woods. And Ms. Woods, I understand that your utilities have been shut off.
Yes, sir.
Which utilities is that?
Gas and electric.
So you have it both with the same company.
Yes, sir.
So if you fall behind and you lose them both, that's pretty tough.
Yes, sir.
I understand you live in Illinois.
Yes.
So how long ago did this happen?
A couple of days ago.
And how does it make you feel?
Not very well. You know, not having electric is kind of bad. Yeah.
And so how is this impacting your family?
Well, not very good, not having any money.
And who is all in your household?
My daughter and my son-in-law and my two grandkids.
And I understand your son-in-law has some health issues. He has to have some medical equipment or something.
Yes, sir.
Which operates by electricity.
Yes.
And when your daughter called me the other day, she told me on the phone that your food had spoiled.
Yes.
And, so that makes it really tough for somebody whose utilities are off, and it's not only being in the dark, that's bad enough, but it also affects a lot of other things.
Yes, sir.
So what are you trying to do to try to get your utilities back on again?
Well, try to get some help.
Have you checked with any other organizations?
No, sir.
Well, we're certainly going to be able to help you with part of it today, and we trust that it's going to get you in the right direction to getting it back on again soon.
Okay, I appreciate that.
Perhaps many of you can identify with this lady's struggles. Many people are struggling today. Many trials and tribulations, problems coming from every side. I must remember, you must remember, that God is in control. We have to go to Him in earnest prayer. We have to seek Him. You and I were talking earlier about how difficult it is being a woman and being homeless and your utilities being shut off, the hurt and the pain. We just got word that one of our dear friends, Robin, was murdered out on the streets. It's hard out there, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
It is really hard out there on those streets. How is it offering you hope by being here at New Life Evangelistic Center?
You are helping me get strength back. You're helping me be encouraged. You're helping me to know I'm going to be all right, and that God loves me, and that this shelter is helping a homeless person like me.
He will help us, won't he? God has everything all under control. How we need to trust Him, how we need to keep looking to Him day after day after day. He's a good God, a great God, a mighty God. And I'm asking you to continue to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center as we trust Him daily to meet the needs that come before us. And we're trying to show people alternatives to just trying to pay electric bill after electric bill. The first thing we try to show them is engage in energy conservation. Utilize the compact fluorescent light bulbs that we give you. Utilize those, they will save you money. So in addition to helping the homeless women, in addition to trying to help people directly with their utility bills when we have the resources, we try to show them alternatives. So we train the homeless on utilizing renewable energy. For example, in a moment you'll hear from Tom. Tom came into our training program here. He works out of our new Bloomfield site, but he wants to explain to you how they utilize solar and wind power in Marshfield, Missouri, at our site in Marshfield. And Tom's going to explain that to you, to just perhaps inspire you to maybe think about how you could go off the grid, to think about how you could save money. But remember, the load drives the system. So in this case, instead of adding more solar panels or more wind generators, you want to try to use as little electricity as possible. That is cutting the load everywhere that you can, using compact fluorescent light bulbs, trying to open the windows when you can instead of using the air conditioning, weatherize the home, just all these different areas. Well, we're going to go to Tom, and he's going to share with you. Now, keep in mind, as Tom is sharing with you how to use solar power and wind power, in this case, Marshfield, Missouri, how it could apply in your life, and also the miracle that God has done in Tom's life and other homeless people's lives that have come here to New Life Evangelistic Center and now have discovered a new beginning because of the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. All of this is possible because of those of you that are praying for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center, those of you that are sharing, and those of you caring. What a blessing you are in the lives of so many people.
Hello, my name is Tom. I'm with the New Life Evangelistic Center. We're here at the renewable energy site here in Marshfield. And right now, the fair is going on, and I am doing the photovoltaic system at the roundhouse. And what we have is we have a collection of solar panels on the roof, circling the circle roof. And what it's doing is it's collecting the energy from the sun, and it's storing it in these battery banks right here, which is right next to me, and producing the electricity going through the charge controller and the inverter to allow the electricity to go from DC to AC. And what we're doing, we have two different hookup systems here, and one of them is for the main line, and the other one is for the solar system. And periodically, they switch these over to save electricity on the cost for their energy bill. And what we have here, this shows here that the battery banks are at right now at 27 volts, and we're at a 24 volt system, and the batteries are at full capacity right now. So, and these right here are supposed to, these right here are the dump load, which is right now, and then with dump load, and when the batteries are fully charged, what it does is takes the excess energy, which is being stored in the batteries after it's fully charged, and getting rid of it. And you can either do a dump load system like this for the wind, from the wind generators, or for the battery banks. And you can also run it straight into the ground with a grounding rod, or you can use a water tank with a heating element in it to burn off the excess energy. Now, we also have wind generators hooked up to this house. It's called the Patriot, which puts out a maximum, with maximum wind velocity, 1,000 watts per hour. And it starts at, producing electricity at 4 to 5 miles an hour winds. Now, what we don't get on a cloudy day to charge up our batteries, our wind generator collects that from the wind to also keep the battery banks charged up. Now, when you would do a complete house totally off-grid, you would have to have a larger battery bank to go with the wattage in which each part of your electrical equipment that you have in the house, you would have to add that up and get your amperages, and you would have to make your battery bank in that capacity to where you can run all your utensils and TVs, lights, and all this, and appliances. Okay, now as you can see, I mean, right now we have all these plugged into the main electrical line, which is off the solar section. But if I was to transfer these plugs here, which is to the guest rooms, over into here, we can hear the system kick on, and it's drawing power from the system. And as you notice, the meter has dropped down from 27 to 26.6. And all I did was switch over from the mains to the to our system, which is one of our guest rooms, and it's collecting the power. Our systems, what we do at our fairs is we show people that they can save money on their electrical bills, as well as go completely off grid for the electricity. The same thing with heating. We have other methods to do with heating, which would also save you on your electrical bill. Also we have ways on fuel to save on diesel, and also cheaper homes that you can build, such as our dome homes and things, our earth home. We also have thank you very much.
Wasn't that exciting? Tom sharing. Tom, who previously was homeless, talking about solar power and hopefully getting you somewhat inspired that you can actually have solar power at your home. For further information, go to www.moreenergy.org. That's www.moreenergy.org. In the greater St. Louis area, keep tuned to 24.2 on a regular basis. And if you live outside that area, go to www.americanrenewableenergy.org. God is so good, and it's so exciting to see Him work in the lives of people that were without hope, experiencing that hope. Do you have hope now?
Yes, sir.
You have hope now?
Yes.
Amen. We want you to have hope now, folks. You don't have to be slaves to the big utility companies. That's why we shared with you what Tom shared with the rest of us here. We want you to know that you can have hope. Now, maybe you feel like you're about to lose your home. Don't give up. Give it to Jesus. We're all facing difficulties and problems right now, but I've seen God's faithfulness all these years, and He will continue. The Bible says that those who remain faithful to the end, the same shall be saved. We need to trust God, remain faithful to Him, and watch Him do exceedingly beyond we can even ask or think. So I'm asking you to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. I want to encourage you to get into the Word of God and read it daily, and let it give you the strength and power that you need to be more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus who strengthens us. I want to encourage you to experience His fullness, His power, His grace, His love in a new and mighty way, watching Him do exceedingly beyond what you can even ask or think. That's His promise to each one of us. So during this program, we've shared with you in a variety of ways that there is hope. Christ is risen. Showed you everything from making biodiesel to using solar power, letting you know that there's help and hope available at New Life Evangelistic Center because of those of you that are sharing. But most of all, get into God's Word and discover the help that's available to you daily through our resurrected Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who's promised, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Yes, there's hope in every area of life because Christ is risen. Walk in the midst of that hope and share it with everybody you know.
Psalm 8. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. From the lips of children and infants, you have ordained praise. Because of your enemies, to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is man that you are mindful of him, the son of man that you care for him? You have made him a little lower than the heavenly beings and crowned him with glory and honor. You made him ruler over the works of your hands. You put everything under his feet, all flocks and herds and the beasts of the field, the birds of the air and the fish of the sea, all that swim the paths of the seas. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.